Have you ever walked out of a doctor's office terrified after hearing terms like degenerative disc disease or herniated disc? You're not alone. I'm Dr. Angela Mailis, and today we are diving into what imaging tests like X-rays, CAT scans, and MRIs really tell you about the spine and when they are actually needed. Let me start with a quick story. Raj, a 47-year-old patient of mine, came to see me for back pain. His doctor had told him his X-rays showed arthritis and his MRI revealed two bulging discs. "Doc, my spine is falling apart." But when I examined him, I found he was simply out of shape. He worked with one of my chiropractors who taught him proper exercise and lifting techniques. After sticking to the exercises for just a few weeks, his pain completely disappeared. And guess what? His X-rays and MRI didn't change at all. So let's first talk about the spine and why it is important. Your spine is literally the backbone of your body. It helps you stand, bend, twist, and protects your spinal cord. It's made up of 33 bones called vertebrae, 7 in your neck, 12 in the upper and middle back, and 5 in the lower back. Between these vertebrae are discs, which work like cushions. Think of them like jelly donuts. The jelly inside, called the nucleus, keeps the disc flexible and strong. The outer ring, called the annulus, keeps the jelly in place. So now, what do imaging tests show? Doctors often use X-rays, CAT scans, or MRIs to look for changes in the spine. Terms like arthritis, degenerative discs, bulging discs, or herniations often show up in reports. But what do these mean? Arthritis shows up as narrowing between the bones in your spine where the cartilage has worn away. Bone spurs or osteophytes might also form. Discs, as we age, can lose water and dry out, leading to cracks in the outer layers, a process called degeneration. You might also hear terms like bulging disc, when the donut is squeezed and the sides bulge out, but then the jelly stays inside. For herniated discs, when the donut tears and the jelly leaks out. Here's the thing. Imaging often shows these changes in people who have no pain at all. For example, in one study of over 3,000 people without, I repeat, without back pain, 37% of 20-year-olds already had some disc degeneration. By age 80, almost 9 out of 10 people had disc bulges. And another study found that 75% of people in their 20s had at least one bulging disc, even though they had no pain. So, if imaging shows degenerative changes, don't panic. These findings are often a normal part of aging, like gray hair or wrinkle. And does age matter? Absolutely. As we age, our discs dry out and change like the rest of our bodies. Take me for example. My spine is full of arthritis on X-rays from the top to bottom, but I don't have pain and stay very active. On the flip side, I had patients with clean imaging who struggled with severe pain. This proves that the severity of changes on imaging does not always match how much pain you feel. So when do you really need imaging? Most of the times, you don't need X-rays, CAT scans, or MRIs for simple back pain. They are usually only necessary if your doctor suspects something serious, like an infection, fracture, or cancer. Ordering imaging for minor back pain does not just add unnecessary costs to the system and radiation exposure to you, but it rarely changes the treatment plan. Doctors can usually figure out what's wrong by asking just detailed questions and performing a physical exam. Remember, imaging is only useful if it matches your symptoms and physical findings. Question for you. Have you ever been told your back or neck is full of arthritis after a test? Did it scare you? Share your story in the comments. Thank you for watching the Pain and Wellness Health Channel. If you found this episode helpful, leave your questions in the comments, like the video, and don't forget to subscribe. See you next time.